Hi, welcome back to the VSDC channel. In today's video, we are excited to show you one of the new features in VSDC 8.2, color keyframes. If you haven't updated yet, we highly recommend doing so to unlock new opportunities for enhancing your video editing experience. With color keyframes, you can now effortlessly create stunning effects with smooth color transitions. In this tutorial, we will guide you through the process of utilizing this powerful tool to its full potential. Let's dive in. To begin, start a new project and go to the gallery of free shapes. In version 8.2, we have added a dedicated gallery that contains shapes commonly used in projects. From there, select a circle and a star and place them on the scene. Use the alignment buttons to align the two shapes horizontally and vertically, ensuring their centers match. The circle will act as the background for the star, which will undergo a gradual color shift, resulting in a stunning animation. To animate the colors of the star shape, click on the shape one time and change the brush settings to point gradient as illustrated on the screen. Next, double-click on the star free shape to access its shape points. Select all the points on the timeline and click on Add Parameters at the bottom of the Parameters window. In the Appeared Small window, choose Brush Gradient Settings. Depending on the number of selected points, you may need to click on Brush Gradient Settings multiple times to apply the gradient to each point. Now that we have introduced the new parameter, let's take a closer look at the available buttons for working with color keyframes. Click on the first shape point to access the Parameters window. Look for a color parameter represented by a rectangular box filled with color. By clicking on this box, a color palette will appear, allowing you to choose a color. Next to the color box, you will find the eyedropper tool, which enables you to select a color from the scene. Within the same parameter, you will notice a diamond-shaped icon and two arrows positioned to the left and right of it. The diamond-shaped icon is used to create and delete keyframes. If the icon is only outlined, it indicates that no keyframe exists. When the icon is filled with color, a keyframe is created. The arrows serve the purpose of navigating between the created keyframes. Additionally, there is an icon with the three dots which opens the keyframe editor window. Let's click on it to access further options. Each object initially has two keyframes, the first one and the last one. These keyframes are represented as square white boxes on the timeline, reflecting the current white color of the star. These keyframes indicate permanent color. To achieve dynamic color changes, you have two options. The first option is to add a new keyframe and assign a color to it. The second option is to switch to another mode, such as linear parameter change or linear parameter change along a trajectory. These modes can be found above the timeline. For now, let's select the second option. To modify the color of the first keyframe, position the cursor on it and double-click the square icon located on the timeline. Alternatively, you can click the color square box in the Parameters window. From there, you can choose a color from the palette or adjust the color by dragging the keyframe icon up or down the Y-axis in the Keyframe Editor window while holding down the Shift button. You will notice that the color of the first keyframe has changed, and the gradient line below the timeline now reflects a gradual color change from color 1 to color 2. Now let's add intermediate keyframes to create more color dynamics. Place the cursor on the timeline where you want to create a keyframe and click on the diamond-shaped icon above the timeline or in the Properties window as illustrated on the screen. You will notice another square-shaped icon appearing between the first and the last keyframe on the timeline. Besides keyframes, let's add markers to synchronize keyframes at a later stage. Press the M key on the keyboard when the cursor is on an intermediate keyframe, and a marker will appear on top of the timeline, The markers will come in handy if you accidentally moved a keyframe and want to return it to the initial position. Repeat these actions to create as many intermediate keyframes as needed. To transfer these keyframes and their color settings to other shape points, there are two options available: to copy the keyframes and paste them in another point, or to synchronize them. To copy, click on the Copy to Clipboard icon above the timeline, close the keyframe editor window, navigate to another point, click on the three dots that lead to the keyframes editor window, and paste the keyframes using the Paste button above the timeline. To synchronize the keyframes in the properties, follow these steps. Go to the Free Shape Points level in the timeline. Select the free shape points you want to synchronize. Locate the synchronization button in the parameters window and click on it. Note that if the keyframes are already synchronized, the button will not appear. By default, the keyframes will be synchronized from the first shape point that was selected. However, if you want to copy keyframes from another shape point, right-click on the synchronization button. From the menu that appears, select the desired shape point that you want to use as the source of keyframes for the other points. By following these steps, you can easily synchronize keyframes between different free shape points in the properties. Moving on to the star's outline. We want to create gradient animation on the outline as well. We will do it through the curve line tool. Now let's add another object to the scene, a curve line. One point is enough at this stage to create the shape, as we will copy the tracking points from the star. To do this, go back to the star free shape, select all the shape points and click Ctrl+C or right-click and choose Copy from the context menu. Then go to the curve line, delete the initially created point and click Ctrl+V or right-click on the timeline and select Paste. Voila! The tracking points of the star shape now fully match the tracking points of the curve line, creating an outline for our shape. Change its type to gradient. Define the start and end colors for the gradient. Now let's add keyframes to the curve line and assign colors to create animation. Start with the start color parameter. Click on the three dots next to it to open the keyframe editor window. Add keyframes at desired points and assign colors to them. Next, move on to the end color parameter and repeat the same process. To ensure the keyframes are at the same level as the start color ones, look for the gray dots on the timeline. If you don't see them, enable the display of keyframes by selecting Pen Start Color in the Edited and Displayed feature located above the timeline. To add movement animation to the curve line, go back to the scene, select the curve line and in the Properties window, set its starting position as linear change from 0 to 100 and set its visible length at 50%. Voila! Now, when you play back the video, you will observe a gradient transition on both the star shape and its outline. If you decide to hide the colored background of the star and the circular shape, you will see an animation where the curve line transforms into the shape of a star. It adds an interesting visual element to the video, creating a dynamic effect. And now a bonus! We will show you how to continue the video when animation already stopped. There are two ways to do it. Use a snapshot or extend keyframes within each object. To create snapshots in your project, follow these steps. Place the cursor on the timeline at the desired location where you want to create the snapshot. Click on an empty spot on the timeline to make sure that no object is selected, otherwise the snapshot will be created for the selected object only. Navigate to the Editor menu and select More Tools. From the drop-down menu, choose Create Snapshot. Once the snapshot is created, it will appear in the Resources window, which displays all the available assets in your project. Drag the snapshot from the Resources window onto the timeline, placing it on a new layer. Extend the duration of the snapshot layer to ensure it continues displaying after the animation ends. The second method to extend keyframes is as follows. Open the keyframe editor window. Look for the button that links the keyframes to the left side as shown on the screen. Click on this button. This ensures that the positions of the keyframes will not change when the object's duration is adjusted. When you extend the object on the timeline, the keyframes will maintain their proportions except for the last one. The last keyframe will automatically extend to match the new duration. If you want to prevent the animation from extending, follow these steps. Double-click on the last keyframe. Copy the color value associated with this keyframe. Move to the previous frame using the Move to Previous Frame button or the left arrow on the keyboard. Create a new keyframe at that frame and paste the copied color value into it. Repeat these actions for each effect as well as the starting point of the curve line animation. Once you have completed these steps, you can freely extend the object on the timeline and the animation will stop after the initially desired animation duration, transitioning into a static representation. Congratulations! You now know how to work with color keyframes and create stunning gradient transitions in VSDC 8.2. If you have any questions or need further assistance, please don't hesitate to leave a comment or contact our support team. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more educational content. Thank you for watching and see you next time!